patient had squamous cell carcinoma of the anal canal and the rectum, and she received the chemo radiation, and with marked improvement of the mass. Now there is just mild thickening, and this is the normal rectal mucosa. This is the interface between the mucosa and the echoendoscope, and this is the muscularis mucosa, the second layer, and this is the submucosa muscularis. This is the submucosa, and these three layers, this is the muscularis mucosa, and this is the submucosa, the third layer, and this is the muscularis propria, three layers. This is a circular muscle, connective tissue band, and longitudinal muscle layer of the muscularis mucosa. So here this is a mucosa, muscularis mucosa, submucosa, circular muscle layer of the muscularis propria, connective tissue band, and longitudinal muscle. The circular muscle layer of the muscularis propria in the rectum will be the internal inner sphincter in the anal canal. And the longitudinal muscle layer and the connective tissue band will form the intersphincteric area. And the external inner sphincter will appear. Now, we will do unfreeze and start to go out. Yes. Starts to go out. Yes, this is the Chowdhury bag head. This is the circular muscle layer of the muscularis propria. Now when we withdraw at the region going to the anal canal, the circular muscle layer will increase in thickness. It will increase in thickness, yes. Yes, it is increasing in thickness. Okay, yes, this is the internal anal sphincter, showing increase in thickness. This is the internal anal sphincter. And the internal anal sphincter will disappear, will end at the distal third of the anal canal, and only the external anal sphincter is there. Yes, this is the internal anal sphincter, and this is ends here. Yes, very nicely, it ends here, and the rest is the external anal sphincter. And this is the enterocentric area, and below is the external anal sphincter, the deep and the superficial part. So this is very nice anatomy. In the anal canal, the circular muscle layer of the muscularis propria increases in thickness to form the internal inner sphincter. It lies high again. Yes. Increase in thickness, and then ends at the distal third of the inner canal, where the subcutaneous part of the external inner sphincter is there, and the rest of the external inner sphincter is here. This is the superficial and deep parts, and this is the intersphincteric area. So again, this is the circular muscle layer of the rectum, now forming the internal anal sphincter in the anal canal, and then the anal sphincter ends here, and the distal third of the anal canal is occupied by the subcutaneous part of the external anal sphincter, and this is the intersphincteric area, the continuation of the longitudinal part of the muscularis propria, and here this is the external anal sphincter, the superficial and the deep parts. Superficial part near the anus, and the deep part more deep. Okay.